starting lineups, and we will start with the visiting Mountaineers of West Virginia. You know about Kevin Jones, and Dennis Colicchio has been averaging 18 points over his last three games. And for the Pitt Panthers, Trey Woodall and Ashton Gibbs in the standing backcourt for Pittsburgh. Woodall, the second leading scorer for Pittsburgh. Ashton at 16.7 points per game. Ashton Gibbs, number one. It is a gold out here at the Pete. Jim Burr, Mike Roberts, Tim Clougherty, our officials, and we are underway. And Jabari Hines, the freshman point guard, number four in blue. Truck Bryant, not getting the start today, struggled in his last game against Louisville. It's the second time these two teams are meeting. Late last month, Pittsburgh won at West Virginia. Here's Miles in the lane, and he gets the first basket of the game.
You know, that's a great start for West Virginia, Mark, because they used up 30 seconds on the clock. They moved the ball around. They got a bucket inside. What a great start. Now, we saw Pitt in man-to-man, and we're going to see him in some zone tonight also.
Yeah, they had a very good time in the zone in Morgantown. Played about 40% zone in that victory, and Jamie Dixon does not play a lot of zone.
Pitt basically plays with three guys outside. They move the ball from side to side really well. They got it back quickly to see Woodall. Now, if Woodall hits that first one like he just did, that's a good sign for him.
Very good sign for Pittsburgh and Trey Woodall, who came back from an abdominal injury that forced him to miss 11 out of 12 games. And that was part of that streak that Pittsburgh lost 8 in a row in open conference season at 0-7.
Had Woodall not gotten hurt, Mark, I think Pitt would be very much in contention for the NCAA bid right now.
Instead, they're 4-9 in conference. 5 seconds to shoot in the possession. Here's the floater up. No good from Gary Brown. Lobbed down court for Robinson. Blocked from behind by Jones. Boy, Kevin Jones is everywhere.
Kevin Jones made a great, great hustle play right there. Instead of being upset maybe because he didn't get a shot at one end, he just busted his tail getting down the other end and saved the bucket.
It's a great outlet pass and an even better block from behind.
Both teams will mostly play defense inside the three-point line, trying to shut off the inside game and then go out and get some stuff on their defensive play moving out. Here comes Jones. Look at him hustle right there. What a great block. Not was it just a great block, it was a great athletic play to prevent from committing the foul.
Kevin Jones, we mentioned, leading the Big East in scoring and rebounding. Also his team's leader in block shots. That was his 29th of the season. 10 to shoot. Gary Brown sends it in the corner to Hines. Kalitschko with the offensive board, but poked away. Ashton Gibbs firing from the left corner. And last touch by West Virginia. Bob Huggins in his fifth season as head coach at his alma mater. You see the numbers aren't great against Pittsburgh in his career. Losing 7 of the 10.
I don't think that Pitt wants to take quick shots like they just did, Mark. I was kind of surprised. Woodall made a great pass, but they're not necessarily a real good three-point shooting team. I thought they'd move the ball around just a little bit more like they're doing here.
Here, the Oakland Zoo, the fan section behind us, as Woodall tries a three and misses it wide of the mark. What would you like to see them complete that offense?
What I'd like to see there is Woodall with a shot fake and then let him drive, because he sees the floor so well. He really wasn't even on balance with that shot like he was on the one that he made. But West Virginia's got to really be careful about getting the big kid out on top against this defense. They've got to have him inside a lot. Right there.
Robinson doing a nice job, and Kalitschko puts it in.
Yeah, when Kalitschko is inside, that's when he's going to really be a problem for the Panther defense. Outside, you don't even have to guard him. You can drop off of him and jam up the middle.
There's Kalitschko, the junior forward from Istanbul, Turkey.
Looks like he's from Turkey, even.
He's a tough player, and right now he and Zana having a good matchup underneath, but Robinson gets in the lane and scores.
Looks
like a physical matchup inside for both these teams.
Well, that was much, much better for Pitt on offense. They took their time. They ended up with the ball in the middle without 10 seconds going off with a three being shot. They really used the clock that time. Neither one of these teams is a particularly good outside shooting team, and therefore I think we're going to see an awful lot of work in terms of getting something going offensively.
Salib Zana picking up the foul. That is his first. Timeout on the floor here, tied at four. Let's go to the studio. Here's John Saunders.
They're playing in Morgantown, Mark, I would imagine.
Here's the series history. Look at that, 1904, 108 years they've been playing basketball. West Virginia has the lead. Their only win, though, in this building, which is 10 years old, happened 7 years ago, back in 2005. And it has been more of a Pittsburgh-dominated series. Of course, Pittsburgh has been among the class of the Big East for the last decade. And if you missed it earlier this week, West Virginia officially will be headed to the Big 12 after a buyout to switch conferences. And so the question is, will this series live on? We know in football it's a dicey issue. Probably not. But in basketball, they'll try to schedule non-conference, but that discussion for a later date, we're told.
They move Kalitzel an awful lot on the high post, and that time they got the ball to him after he had set a screen and had a little opening going down the lane. I don't think they want to get him outside. You're going to see him right here. Sets the screen, makes a great move. Poor help defense on Pitt's part. Had a chance to move in and take away that move to the bucket and didn't. We've said it a lot over the year that any time the ball is put on the floor to initiate a drive, help defense has got to move to help on that drive. As soon as the ball is dribbled, help has to get in there.
Dante Taylor a little late. He picked up the foul, his first. Lance Patterson, Lamar Patterson, rather, holding the ball. Now in the lane. He's been playing better of late as well for Jamie Dixon. This team goes as Trey Woodall goes. Ball on the floor loose and a turnover as Jabari Hines comes up with it. Keaton Miles looking to get it inside to Jones, but Robinson's doing a nice job defending in the post, and he strips Jones. Loose ball on the floor, and they'll call tight possession, and the arrow is going the other way.
We're back up on Hines just a minute, Mark. Boy, you made a really good observation with that play that he made. He was on his back. He got the ball. It's awfully difficult not to walk when you're on your back, and he prevented himself from doing that. That was a heck of a defensive play.
Pittsburgh coming off a loss to Seton Hall where the last 8 minutes of the game just could not get it going. They won four straight after Trey Woodall's return, lost two tough road games, and now at 4-9 in the Big East. They haven't lost 10 games in the Big East since the 99-2000 season, and an illegal screen is going to turn it over. Second foul on Dante Taylor. And a look at Jamie Dixon in his ninth year as the head coach of Pittsburgh. 231 victories here, and 12 of them coming at the expense of their rivals from 70 miles south on I-79.
Well, that was a tough call on Taylor right there.
That's going to send him to the bench.
I was just about to say what a good screen he set, and I think the referee and I had different idea on what a good screen was.
And so Malcolm Gilbert, a freshman, 6'11 forward from Delaware, and quickly tested and sees Dennis Kalitzla score over him. Kalitzla's got seven here in the early going.
See, that's where Kalitzla has to be. We talked about that earlier. And as long as he's in there, they're going to have a really good scoring opportunity. Time to show that one. But when he's inside, he is a real threat against Pittsburgh's inside defense, and they've got to keep him in there.
Coach, and if you're Malcolm Gilbert, who's just in as a freshman, does he have to do a better job of making sure he doesn't get the ball so deep?
Well, that's going to be hard. He's so big, Mark, that you can't get around him. You've got to get help. The ball's in coming into him. You've got to have help.
Lamar Patterson hitting the three-pointer. He's a 41% three-point shooter this year, but he's made 10 of his last 20, so 50% in the last few games.
Now we're going to see Pitt in zone, and they're going to work a little high-low in there with Jones and Kalitzla.
Well, the zone proves to work well, as it did January 30th in Morgantown, a Pittsburgh win. Woodall with the pull-up jumper.
See, that's Woodall going a little bit too far. He really didn't have control of the basketball when he took that shot. He's got to be careful about coming in on the dribble and taking what is not a good shot.
That's a nice job by Patterson to help out on defense. Spin move, Robinson. Jones thought he had a block, but it's going to be a foul. He got a piece of the arm.
Real good spin. May have carried the ball even. Drew the foul. Good move going to the bucket. Now, the thing about that that's so good, Mark, is that he's going to the bucket as opposed to what Woodall did the last time, taking a jump shot off of kind of an unbalanced approach. We went all the way to the bucket here, and he went into the bucket, Robinson did, and had a chance to both score from the foul line, as he did, and from the bucket.
Ends up splitting that and getting Pitt to within 1 point. Physical start to this backyard brawl.
Pitt's going to stay in this zone quite a bit here, and West Virginia will do a good job of moving up and down, but they've got to split the floor. They've split the floor, and they get the ball back inside.
That sweeping left-hand hook from Pritchler does not fall, and Patterson has the rebound. I think if you're Jamie Dixon, you don't mind him taking that shot, but Palicchio's very proficient at that shot as John Johnson turns it over on the travel.
I think they're gonna do a good job.
Ohio State hoping to remain atop the Big Ten. They visit rival Michigan. Saturday primetime presented by DirecTV.
Now we want to see it. Now they got the floor spread against that 2-3, Mark. You want three on top so they can do a good job with somebody getting open, and then you're going to be able to get something inside, just like they got there. I think Taylor made a good move to get to the bucket.
Yep, and Kevin Jones, who found that little seam right at the elbow. Apparently tipped back into the backcourt. Robinson's spin looked to dish, but off the foot of a West Virginia player. That'll bring us to a media timeout as Jamie Dixon's Panthers 4-9 on the season in the conference.
All right, now they've got the zone spread right here. They look inside, really good move. Get the ball at the foul line where you've got the shot. He was a very good student, too. He was an honor student, but that picture looked like the barber shops had been closed in Morgantown for about 2 months.
I bet you didn't like the 70s too much, the haircuts.
I survived. Looks a little bit better with his haircut there.
I think he would appreciate your approval, too. 707 victories. In his 30 years, a Morgantown native, and back with his team. And the inbounds play off the screen.
Boy, that is the absolute best inbounds play you can have. Screen the shooter. Pitt did a great job with a double screen right there and got a wide open shot. That's as good out-of-bounds play as we've seen all year.
Work to perfection. Pitt within one. And West Virginia facing this zone defense the last number of possessions.
Well, they've got to keep it spread again. They've got to have those three guys on top, and they've got one down in the corner, which is not what they really wanted.
And Truck Bryant, who's used to starting coming off the bench tonight, was just 3-for-17 for Bob Huggins in his last game, including 2-for-10 from three, bags one from three-point land there.
You know, both teams have used the three-point shot pretty well here, or the outside shot at least pretty well, and they're not real good statistically in that area.
Especially West Virginia comes in low 30% from three-point range. Ashton gets on the drive, pulls up, is floated. Tip no good. The freshman Gilbert has it, lost it on the floor. And Kevin Jones comes up with it. Now, would you like to see a little faster transition when you're coming up against a zone?
No, not really. The zone that time was all the way down the floor. But if you've got an even break with the defense, then you want to get it down. But you want to have a spread court when you're doing it. That time, West Virginia was coming down with four guys kind of in each other's shadow. And get into the zone, offensive set against the zone defense. Then you want the court spread. Make them come from side to side. They've got an excellent opportunity inside. West Virginia does with those two inside kids they have. But I don't like the guy down in the corner. I don't think the guy should be in the corner where he is. That's Hines down in the corner.
That's Kalichla getting cut off by Malcolm Gilbert down low. The other way, J.J. Moore lost control of it. Down court, Kalichla against Woodall, and he travels and turns it over.
That's a good call. That's a good call by the trailing official who's paying attention, and Kalichla just did a little bit more than he can actually capable of doing.
USA chance. Mocking Kalichla from Istanbul, Turkey, who came to America for his last year of high school. Didn't speak much English. Told he learned his English from television. Now putting together a nice career at West Virginia. Halfway through the first half, J.J. Moore will line up a three, and he knocks it down.
Well, this is an interesting start to this game for us, Mark, with Pitt not being a particularly good outside shooting team, really using it to their advantage.
And J.J. Moore was just 4 for 31. That's 12% from three. Bryant finds Jones and gives the weak side rebound.
Jones didn't really get set on that shot. Good move by Woodall. Set it up. Let's see what you can get by moving around a little bit.
And here's a steal by Gary Brown. And Brown will miss the layup. But Bryant able to clean it up. Fortunate for his teammate.
Well, Bryant made a great defensive play down here. A steal. But the ball was kind of exposed to him. Almost like it was handed to him.
Struck Bryant with five off the bench. Pittsburgh was looking to take its first lead. Three-point attempt in and out by Patterson. Hines has the rebound.
West Virginia kind of got caught there in to switch or not to switch, and that resulted in an open shot.
Here's Brown lining up a three. Woodall tried to get his own rebound. Fight for it and got it. Reverse puts it in. Never gave up on that basket.
Well, it was a great effort by Woodall, but I question him trying to take the ball to the bucket against all the blue shirts that were in there. He did a great job coming out of it with a good play, but that's not what they want coming down the floor in conversion to offense.
At the Oakland Zoo going now, the gold out as they hop up and down here at the Pete.
What I'd like here, Mark, would be dribble the ball in there. Use the dribble against the zone. Go into that crack. Make two guys play one, and you're playing four on three the rest of the way.
Hines floater never touched the rim. It's a shot clock violation. And the ball will go to Pittsburgh after the timeout. Panthers still looking for the lead. And they'll have a chance after the break.
Well, there's a lot of defense being played by both teams out there tonight, Mark. Bob didn't like, somebody didn't do what they were supposed to do, and he's a demonstrative guy. But what he's doing is telling a kid, I think it was Hines in this case, hey, you've made a couple of plays out there that have really hurt our team. Let's get your act together. It isn't just a confrontation between a coach and a player. It's a coach's responsibility to see that each kid is doing his part as it's supposed to be done, and that's all Bob Huggins was doing there. He was just coaching.
And Jabari Hines not on the floor is West Virginia.
I think he was a little madder at Hines than we thought he was. Maybe.
That's the view from the West Virginia fans high above Peterson Event Center. Now back courtside where Pittsburgh looks for the lead. Woodall against Truck Bryant.
West Virginia is doing a really good job protecting against the drive here. Really good job protecting against the drive. They've had really, really good defense in the last two possessions down. Brown's size out on the perimeter makes him very difficult to shoot over.
This is Aaron Brown, number 12 in blue, and a turnover, but the pass ahead way out in front of Gibb. That's the seventh turnover for Pittsburgh here in the first half.
Now, see, this is where I'd like that third man to come outside against the zone. Never pass the ball in the direction you dribble against the zone. Dribble one way, pass the other way. See, they're covering that corner. And it's much harder to cover the baseline when there are just two guys down there and those two bottom guys have to come up from the corners to play defense.
Woodall got a hand on the steal. Here's Gibbs, open for just a moment, but missing on the three-point attempt.
Well, that was a perfect execution on a ball screen, and we had to get some switch action from the defense, from the West Virginia defense, to take away what was really a good shot.
There's Jones underneath, and that's going to be a goaltend against Gilbert. Give the two to Jones. And by 5 Hour Energy on ESPN, ESPN3, and also streaming live on WatchESPN.com. And check out that graphic. We told you about the 7 turnovers. Pittsburgh only 6 field goals made here in the first 14 minutes. And the backyard brawl. Gibbs, there's number 7, knocks down a deep 2.
All right, Gibbs came, set his move up off the screen, and that time there had to be a West Virginia switch, and there wasn't. Gibbs took real good advantage of a switch situation that wasn't there.
Aaron Brown to Aaron Brown in the corner. Truck Bryant, no good on the 3, but it's tipped out. Aaron Brown, a block by Gilbert. Woodall saves it and then throws it into the body of Aaron Brown. It'll be Pittsburgh ball. Nice play.
Boy, that's as good a reaction from a help side defender, Mark, as you're ever going to see with Gilbert, as he comes out of the pack and comes out and gets a piece of this shot right there.
Pittsburgh has not led in this game. And a nice job by Malcolm Gilbert, the 6'11 freshman center from Smyrna, Delaware.
The defense for both teams has really dominated the game at their defensive ends of the floor. Right there's an example of steal by Bryant.
And he'll dunk it home with one hand. So yet again, Pittsburgh coming so close, but turnovers hurting them.
Well, that time they were careless with it, but that was really, really a good job done with the defensive pressure on the ball. Bryant really got into the ball.
He's got 7 coming off the bench, not getting the start tonight. Gibbs thought about a 3.
I once called Bobby Huggins after a game I think they'd played with Marquette to talk to him about how good I thought his defense had played in that particular game. And they're doing the same thing here tonight. There's great help by the big guy, but they don't cover for him inside. Jones had to drop back from the foul line then. Jones became a spectator when Kalichley went out to get some pressure on the shooter. Jones had to move to help.
And Talib Zana coming up with the basket. 4th assist for Trey Woodall. Offense moves so much better when he's playing well. Good ball movement here for West Virginia. 3-pointer won't go down for Aaron Brown. And here comes Pittsburgh again for looking for that elusive lead. Gibbs, blocking foul against West Virginia, will get Ashton Gibbs to the line. Truck Bryant picks up his first.
All right, we're going to see here good movement, get into that gap, good feed inside. The inside defense kind of went to sleep there for West Virginia.
Ashton Gibbs, 85% free thrower, 87% for his career. And he ties the game. 3rd time the game has been tied, a free throw away from the Panthers' first lead, as Nasir Robinson comes back into the lineup. I think Jamie Dixon, who's had trouble with his bench so far this year, has to be happy with the bench players so far tonight.
They've done a good job keeping the game right within their grasp. And with neither team, though, has it gotten away from one or the other.
Pittsburgh's first lead at 21-20, but we expect a close game in this series.
Now, see, I'd like to have Bryant out right now, where you've got 3 guys, and you don't need to bring your big kid out the screen if you've got 3 guys on top against that zone. Your 2 big kids can be working inside. See, Jones can't do a thing out there, and neither Kalichley, but the 2 of them together inside would be very, very difficult to handle.
Dangerous pass there. Floater, but a travel will wipe out the basket.
But the travel started with his initial footwork. When he was setting up the drive, he moved both feet. He didn't have a pivot foot, but the penetration got him an open shot, and that's what we're talking about.
The emotion of the backyard brawl, the 184th edition. Bob Huggins into it, his players into it, and a 1-point game as Jamie Dixon sweats it out early. All right, John, we look forward to it. This guy's pretty brave, the West Virginia fan amongst the Oakland Zoo, surviving somehow through the commercial. And Pittsburgh has the one-point lead. Well, it's kind of sad, Coach. A rivalry's coming to an end as West Virginia's headed to the Big 12 next year. Pittsburgh's headed to the ACC either the year after or 2 years after that. We see Kansas, Missouri, Syracuse, Georgetown. Kind of sad to see these great rivalries.
Well, you know, this is the best rivalry in this part of the country, and surely the two athletic departments will come together and play non-conference games with each other, which sustains that rivalry that I think you mentioned went all the way back to 1904.
1904, and they played every year since World War I. Now, next year, maybe the percentages might be slow because they're just, you know, now finding out West Virginia will not be in the conference as Woodall's floater goes down. And Jamie Dixon mentioning how the non-conference schedule's almost complete. So next year may not happen, but one would think that the year after that and on, they would meet every year.
Now, there's a three-man spread we're talking about, but use the dribble. Don't just pass the ball. Take it in there. Use the dribble. Use the dribble again. See, they're not. This is the easiest thing to cover is the pass.
Evan Jones on the baseline drive. That ends six straight Pittsburgh points.
But even with that, as they move the ball to the right side, the bottom defender had to come up and play the ball. The offense was set to take the shot from the baseline, and that's why they got an open shot. Bring those two bottom guys up, you're going to get a lot of chances on the baseline.
Trying to throw over the top and truck Bryant. At 6'2", able to get up there and tip the ball away. Another Pittsburgh turnover.
I think I'd stick a pin in Kalichi's rear end to get him down the floor a little quicker.
Pass underneath. Jones fouled. Ball does not go down. And Kevin Jones will get to the free throw line. Nasir Robinson picking up his first. That is the fifth team foul against Pittsburgh in the half. And, you know, backyard brawl, we expect a foul fest. That really hasn't happened here in the first half.
Well, even with that in mind, there has been great defense. And so many times defense results in grabbing or holding, but not here. These kids at both ends have done a very good job with their defense.
Kevin Jones, you see the numbers, so impressive. Only two players in conference history have led in scoring and rebounding over a season. Jones trying to become number three. He picked West Virginia over Pittsburgh. He's a kid from Mount Vernon, New York. So he could have been on either side of this rivalry. 6'8 senior knocking down both free throws, giving the Mountaineers the lead back.
One of the greatest assets you can have in basketball is a big kid who's going to be in the area where he draws a lot of fouls, who can shoot free throws. Now, Kalichli moved right there to help from his defensive position inside, playing Zana.
That gives off the screen, curling, but couldn't knock down the shot.
There, they've got three-man spread up on top again now. Now, take it right in on him.
Bryant flashing into the key.
Work the middle, work the middle.
Jones, a top three-pointer.
Now, I don't quite understand that one. I'd want Jones right where he can catch it and lay it in and go to the free throw line.
There's the tip going down by Talib Zana.
Zana followed that drive all the way. So many times the big guy becomes a spectator on the drive. That drive started and Zana followed it all the way to the bucket. Nobody was there for the block out and he got him an easy two.
Coming up on 1 minute to go in this first half. Critical part of the season for both teams. Kalichla underneath scores.
Where did that come from? Penetration. Great penetration from on top resulted in a bucket.
9 points for Dennis Kalichla. Had seven early. As we go back and forth in Pittsburgh, 40 seconds to go in the half.
Now there, Jones helped on the ball screen and got back on defense. Did a great job of getting back to his own man.
10 to go on the shot clock. Woodall penetrates, but can't complete on the floater. So the shot clock is off and West Virginia up one with the final possession. And Bob Huggins wants to talk it over and design something. So we'll see what he comes up with. 14 and a half seconds to go, first half in Pittsburgh. We've had four ties and four lead changes, and all the lead changes in the last 4 minutes. West Virginia with a one-point lead. What do you think Bob Huggins is trying to draw up in that huddle right now?
Well, I think that he's going to want to go inside where they've got a chance not just to get a bucket, but to go to the free throw line as well. And I think that that is, I'll be surprised if they're certainly not going to shoot it quickly. They don't want Pitt to get an offensive opportunity. And that's exactly what they're going to do. They're going to let it run down to 6 seconds, I think. And here it goes. They're going to try and get, there's the penetration.
Truck Bryant for three. 2 seconds to go. Woodall from half court missed. And we've got a one-point game at halftime. Kevin Jones with 8 points and four rebounds. Trey Woodall, five assists to go with those 6 points. Pittsburgh this year 0-7 when they trail at halftime. And they trail by 1 point here at the break against West Virginia.
And you know, Kalitzley has added an awful lot to the offense in this game, too, along with Jones.
Let's go to the studio. Here's John Saunders.